Hello class 10, welcome back to day 6. Today we are going to learn The Little Match Girl written by Hans Christian Andersen. It was bitterly cold. Snow was falling and darkness was gathering, for it was the last evening of the old year. It was New Year's Eve. References to winter in literature may refer to death, old age, pain, loneliness, despair, or an end. The season provides the setting for painful messages, rebirth, and hope. A cold place could hint at your loneliness or unhappiness in some way. And here I want to introduce a term called symbolism. What is symbolism? It's a device used in literature. Especially, it is one predominant feature of Hans Christian Andersen's writing. Many a symbol is scattered here and there in this story, children. So, it is a device used to bring conciseness to the development of plot and character. What is conciseness? Conciseness means the extent to which a piece of writing communicates clear information in as few words as possible. So, it's a device used to bring conciseness to the development of plot and character in the limited scope of short story and to indicate some deeper meaning through it. Short stories cannot be elaborated to 10 to 15 pages, right? So, it has to end within 2-3 pages. That's why we call it a short story. So, in short stories, the symbolism plays a vital role. Once again, I'll read the story. It was bitterly cold, snow was falling, and darkness was gathering. For it was the last evening of the old year, it was New Year's Eve. Such abrupt beginning is on one hand a symbolic projection of the girl's bleak existence leading to the arrival of eternal nightfall in her life. And on the other hand, it is a new beginning in the girl's life, in the abode of blissful eternity. So much message has been conveyed to you in between these two lines. In the cold and gloom, a poor little girl walked bareheaded and barefoot through the streets. The poor girl's utter wretchedness is expressed by putting stress on the initial letter of B in the two consecutive words bareheaded and barefoot. She had been wearing slippers, it is true, when she left home. But what good were they? They had been her mother's, so you can imagine how big they were. When she left her house, she had her slippers on. But what good had they been? They were very big slippers, way too big for her, for they belonged to her mother. The little girl had lost them as she ran across the street to escape from two carriages that were being driven terribly fast. The little girl had lost them running across the road where two carriages had rattled by terribly fast, which symbolizes the life of people who are caught up in a fiercely competitive struggle for wealth or power. We don't have time for others, especially for poor people. One slipper could not be found and a boy had run off with the other, saying that it would come in very handy as a cradle some day when he had children of his own. One slipper she had not been able to find again, and a boy, I repeat, a boy, not a married man. Your boy had run off with the other, saying he could use it very well as a cradle some day when he had children of his own. So the boy, who is probably of her age and probably of her status, even did not have the pity for the girl, and he had run off with the other. So the little girl walked about the streets on her naked feet, which were red and blue with the cold. In her old apron, she carried a great many matches, and she had a packet of them in her hand as well. Nobody had bought any from her, and no one had given her a single penny all day. She crept along, shivering and hungry, the picture of misery, poor little thing. And so the little girl walked on her naked feet, which were quite red and blue with the cold. In an old apron, she carried several packages of matches and she held a box of them in her hand. No one had bought any from her all day long and no one had given her a cent. One more symbolism here. The girl's naked feet, which were red and blue with the cold, is representative of the nakedness of the so-called civilized society where the poor girl is deprived of her basic rights. It was New Year's Eve. Everyone was moving around on the streets, but no one had the time to look at this poor girl who was trying to sell her matches. And just notice, she's not begging. She is only selling the matches. And people are not ready to buy from the platform. Probably because she is oddly dressed or poorly dressed, or her appearance is not as attractive as a salesman or a sales girl in a big shopping complex. Not only was she shivering because of cold, but also hungry, and the picture of misery, poor little thing. The snowflakes fell on her long golden hair, which curled so prettily about her neck. But she did not think of her appearance now. Lights were shining in every window, and there was a glorious smell of roast goose in the street, for this was New Year's Eve and she could not think of anything else. Here another symbolism you have to note. Her hair got entangled with snowflakes, which are nothing but trials and tribulations in her life. The girl had long beautiful hair which hung in pretty curls over her neck, just like the hair of any rich girl. In all the windows, lights were shining. It was New Year's Eve. In all the windows, lights could be seen, and there was a wonderful smell of roast goose, for it was the New Year's Eve. Yes, she thought of that. She huddled down in a heap in a corner formed by two houses, one of which projected further out into the street than the other. But though she tucked her little legs up under her, she felt colder and colder. She did not dare to go home, for she had sold no matches and earned not a single penny. Her father would be sure to beat her, and besides, it was so cold at home, for they had nothing but the roof above them, and the wind whistled through that, even though the largest cracks were stuffed with straw and rags. Her thin hands were almost numb with cold. If only she dared pull just one small match from the packet, strike it on the wall, and warm her fingers. Just a while ago, we learnt that there were lights shining in every window and smell of roast goose in the street, which also symbolically represent the comfort of the rich, whereas the little girl is denied of all these things which she desires to have. She felt colder and colder. Again, the repetition of initial C letter, through which the writer suggests boring, monotonous poverty of the girl. In a corner formed by two houses, one of which projected farther out into the street than the other, she sat down and drew up her little feet under her. She was getting colder and colder, but did not dare to go home. What was the reason? Because she had not sold any matches nor earned a single cent. And it seems her father would surely beat her if she had gone home without selling the matches. Besides, it was cold at home, for they had nothing over them but a roof through which the wind whistled, even though the biggest cracks had been stuffed with straw and rags. Her hands were almost dead with cold, and she was tempted to take out one match and strike it so that she could warm her fingers. With this, we'll come to the end of this class. I'll ask you some questions. What is symbolism? What is foreshadowing? Describe the little match girl's father's character. Till we meet again, take good care of your health, and thank you.